Appearing before the Parliament Select Committee that investigates into operations of the National Council of Sports, the Uganda Boxing Federation, UBF President Moses Mohanji pinned NCS for wasting the 4.8 billion shillings on officials instead of the athletes.
The only benefit was the 7.5 million shillings given to them as allowance. That's from the government of Uganda. Why I think they should have benefited more, because there are people who are not competing, who are just fans, spectators who came to watch the games, and some walked away with 60 million shillings, 56, 100 million, and all sorts of figures. So why would someone who's not competing bag 100 and so million shillings, yet a boxer who's in the ring will go 7.5 million shillings? Myself, as president of the federation, I got 7.5 million shillings. But there are people I know, staff of council, who got 56 million shillings. And you wonder what they had to do to deserve that kind of allowance.
Mohanji told the committee that over 70 officials who escorted the team did not even save time to watch Ugandan athletes play, but rather turned into tourists in England. He also submitted that the six boxers did not get playing kits despite the fact that money was released.
You wanted more information about those who were in the games villages and those who are not in the games villages. This information is easy for you to access. Just contact, you see what I'm saying is, given the circumstances, there's some high level of secrecy about some of this information. But if you contact the UOC, which represents the Commonwealth Games in the country, they will give you a list of those that were in the games villages and those that aren't supposed to be in the games villages. There are those that were accredited and those that were not accredited. Whoever wasn't accredited was not even supposed to be in these games.
They must be feeling it somewhere that some federations could be weak, briefcase, and causing questions to other federations which are stable. When the chair of the Boxing Federation came alone and I made a comment earlier, I also asked myself very many questions if the federation has the capacity and the financial management capacity, because we don't see your finance person, we don't see your ED. Do you really have the management and governance structure that can manage this fund, or possibly that's why you may be having some challenges?
The FUFA president, Moses Magogo, also appeared before the committee and accused the National Council of Sports for illegally failing to release 1.5 billion shillings, which was meant for FUFA in the last financial year. Magogo told the committee that the last financial year, FUFA was meant to get 10 billion, but FUFA only received 8.5 billion, despite the fact that finance had released all the funds to National Council of Sports to extend it to FUFA.
The PSST of 10 billion came. National Council resisted it, much as it was an instruction, to the point that there was an inquiry, a forensic audit done by the Minister of Finance, and there was an audit query as to why FUFA was not getting the 10 billion. In accordance with the letter from PSST. And from that point, National Council started following that directive.
Given the limited budget allocation and grant to Council.
Both Magogo and Mohanji decried impunity at National Council of Sports, perpetuated by the General Secretary, Dr. Bennett Patrick Ogwell, whom they accused of frustrating funding of the federations.
A number of federations who have failed to set their house in order.
Participate actively in the annual budgeting process, because my thinking is that before the National Council brings their budget to Parliament, the beneficiaries must be part of the process that develops the budgets. Otherwise, National Council would not know the amount of money that you need unless you are part and parcel of the budgeting process.
Ogwell and other National Council of Sports officials faced the committee on Tuesday and blamed the poor funding of sports federations to lack of accountability on the side of federations. Story compiled by Fred Kajiri for the news.
Conclude.